Hi guys, welcome back to Random Lifestyle Vlog. So today I just thought that this might be a good time for another fragrance haul video because I did spoil myself with some new fragrances this winter. So yeah, let me show you what I purchased one by one. So today I'm going to show you five fragrances. Some of them were blind buy, some of them were actually known to me before, so it's not like a 100% blind buy type of haul, it's just mixed. But yeah, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about it when I actually get to the fragrances that I know. But I'm starting with a blind buy, and this is going to be Nomad by Chloe. This is Eau de Toilette. So I was actually wondering, I wasn't sure if I should buy Eau de Toilette or Eau de Parfum. I just went for Eau de Toilette because this is one of those like a shipper fragrances, and I'm a little bit of afraid of that family. The reason is that it kind of associated with Chanel number 5 in my head, and this fragrance, Chanel number 5, obviously it's a little bit too much in my head, it's like too overpowering, it almost gives me like a headache. So I'm a little bit iffy when it comes to shipper fragrances. This is like a shipper floral, so I just wasn't sure if I'm ready for that. So I decided to go for Eau de Toilette. They are a little bit lighter, and I have to tell you, I don't know why I was afraid of it. This actually smells really nice. This is more like a, this is like lychee, white flowers, and oak moss. There's like a lot of oak moss, so I don't think this is a safe blind buy unless you do like shipper fragrances, because that oak moss might be a little bit too irritating if you don't really like those notes. For me, luckily, I like it. I don't really like that oak moss thing. I think this fragrance is more spring, summertime. I wouldn't really wear it now in winter, so it will have to wait for its time. But this is a really nice fragrance, and it actually makes me very curious about the Eau de Parfum. From what I know, the Eau de Parfum smells differently, and the differences are, because you know, sometimes the differences between Eau de Toilette and Eau de Parfum are not that substantial, but in this particular case I actually read that the Eau de Parfum smells differently. So I'm quite curious. So I'm not really sure if I need Eau de Parfum from this end, but I am tempted. I have to tell you, I'm tempted. And I do love the packaging too. I mean, the bottle. So next one is this. Sunset Riot by All Saints. And this is one of those fragrances that is described as one of the dupes for Baccarat Rouge. And I have to tell you, I kind of find it almost satisfying to try and test those like so-called dupes on my skin and decide if they are really similar to the original one or if they're different. I just find it very interesting for some reason. So I decided to buy this fragrance, especially considering the fact that this is quite inexpensive brand. As you can see, the bottle is quite big. This is 100 mils. It's very simple. I actually quite like it. So yeah. Is it a dupe for a Baccarat Rouge? Do you know what? On the first sniff, the opening is very similar. But then, on the second sniff, it actually changes. It becomes more... Well, if I just smell straight from the bottle, it smells like Baccarat Rouge, yes. But on the skin, or in the air, you just get this very herbal note on the second sniff. It's not like a nice herbal, and it's not nice to me. It's more like a medicinal type of herbal thing. It smells a bit like a hospital. It's like almost that metallic scent, I would say. I just need to respray it for now. But yeah. Yeah. It just gives me that really weird medicinal vibe, which is not the most amazing. But it lasts for like around, I don't know, a couple of minutes. And then it's gone. And then you have something that quite reminds me of Baccarat Rouge, but it's airier, it's creamier, it's closer to your skin. So I'll probably say that this is quite close to Baccarat Rouge. I wouldn't say it's a dupe, because it's a little bit different, but it is quite similar. And if you want to have a Baccarat Rouge version that you actually can wear in an office, this is probably a good idea. So the original Baccarat Rouge and some of the dupes, they are quite powerful. So this means that they're not the best fragrances to wear in the office, for example, because you can cause some headaches. But this one is actually close to skin, so if you're just strong enough to survive this medicinal note for a couple of minutes, it just settles down and it's pretty much gone after a couple of minutes. If you are able to survive this, then this is a good office version of Baccarat Rouge. Okay, so let's stay for a bit in this like a Baccarat Rouge vibe. This is not something that's considered to be a dupe for sure, but there is a tiny resemblance. So this is Banana Republic Dark Cherry and Amber. And the resemblance is actually in the opening, this like cedar amber note that kind of gives you almost this candy floss vibe. It is there. I'm not sure if you're aware, but you should never eat anything spicy or too aromatic before testing new fragrances, because it might actually change how the fragrance smells on your skin. That kind of makes sense, right? And I've never actually noticed that situation in my case. I mean, most of the fragrances, I pretty much can spray them on my like a normal day and on my more spicy day, and they smell, if not identical, smell quite similar. So this is one of those fragrances when I actually realized how important it is not to eat any spicy aromatic foods before testing something new. Unless this is your regular diet, obviously, and you only eat aromatic and spicy food, then this is your natural state, and obviously you can try it like that then. But for me, I'm going to tell you about my experience with this fragrance on a normal day and on a spicy day. Okay, so starting with my normal date, first thing I got, and I was quite surprised, I got this Baccarat Rouge opening vibe. It actually lingers, on top of this fragrance for like a couple of hours. So if you love Baccarat Rouge, you might actually try this one. It's different. It's much sweeter. It's much juicier. You get those like dark fruits in there. I didn't get any cherry on my normal day, obviously. There's amber. There's like one of those like sexy but not too sexy, not too in your face fragrances. It's quite young, but it's not like too girly. So after that, opening settles down, you get like really nice, sweet, juicy fragrance, but with some edge to it, because as I mentioned before, this Baccarat Rouge note kind of lingers on top of that. So it actually makes it more sophisticated, I would say, but it's not like one of those super elegant fragrances, more on the sexy side. So this was my experience on a normal day. So trust me, I was extremely surprised when I actually tested this on my spicy day. First of all, I didn't get any Baccarat Rouge note at all. Like at all. Like there was no Baccarat Rouge. I was surprised, but it was like completely gone. I thought I was like losing my mind or something, but guess what I got? I got that lost cherry. I didn't really get that cherry before. I got like a pure cherry scent in the opening, and that was pretty much the only note I could get from that. Then with the dry down, I actually got back all those previous juicy dark fruit notes, and I got back that Baccarat Rouge lingering note on top of that, but the opening was so different, I couldn't really believe, I mean, if I didn't know any better, I would probably think that these fragrances were like completely different ones. So the opening was so different on my skin. So yeah, that's a word of advice. If you want to try your fragrances, don't really use too much of spices in your food on the day before. So yeah, definitely for me, really lovely fragrance. I will probably wear it in spring and summer, but I kind of get how people can even like wear it in winter because it's quite warm or even warming. So yeah, definitely a good one. So these three that I just mentioned were my blind buys. I didn't really know what to expect. I just kind of blind bought them. They were not none of them were like super expensive, so I was like okay for me. And now I have two planned buys. I kind of tried them before, and the main reason for that, I mean, there are two reasons. First of the price, they're not cheap, these ones. And the second reason is that they are by Tom Ford. And Tom Ford, as much as I like his fragrances, they are not crowd pleasers. I mean, some of them are amazing for me, but some of them are just really hard to stand. And I'm not saying they're bad quality or anything like that, but it's just something about them that you kind of either hate them or love them, it seems to me. So yeah, let's start with this one. This is Tom Ford Noir. So for me, the name of this fragrance describes the scent perfectly. So noir means dark or black in French, and this is how it actually smells. It's quite dark, it's sweet, but it's not your typical gourmandish fragrance. It has some orange, it has some ginger, it has some flowers in it. And some sandalwood. It's, for me, it's just amazing fragrance. It was not a blind buy. I would be a little bit afraid to get Tom Ford as a blind buy, as I mentioned before, but this one is just gorgeous. It's sexy, it's very feminine, but it's not like floral feminine, it's like dark feminine fragrance. I don't know how to better describe it, but this is actually an amazing fragrance. And this is one of those fragrances that could be easily described as those like bad bitch mode fragrances. So yeah, definitely amazing. If you are thinking about buying it, try it first. And the last fragrance is another Tom Ford one, and this is Velvet Orchid. And I was actually debating if I should get this one or the Black Orchid, but I don't really know how much I love Black Orchid. I do like it, but I'm not really sure if this is going to be a fragrance that I'm going to enjoy for like a longer period of time, so I decided to get this one. Again, I wouldn't say it's a safe blind buy. This is one of those fragrances that you'll probably love or hate. It's actually quite interesting, it's quite boozy. There's like a sweet alcohol in it, like rum or whiskey. There's some flowers, again some wooden accords like sandalwood. It smells lovely, but I wouldn't say it's a safe fragrance. This is quite strong feminine fragrance again. Nothing too, I mean, it is floral. It is floral, don't get me wrong, but this is nothing like delicate and floral and pastely. This is more like one of those dark scents. Dark, sexy scents. It's not as bad bitch as the previous one, but it's still somewhere there. So these are my five recent purchases, fragrance purchases. What do you guys think? Have you tried any of these fragrances? If so, what do you think about them? What's your opinion? I would love to hear your thoughts, especially about these Baccarat Rouge kind of dupes. I don't know why I actually did that on Baccarat Rouge. Baccarat Rouge dupes fragrances. So I'm really curious how similar you find them to the original one. So I don't know if you've noticed, but we are trying to post regularly now on Thursdays, Saturdays and Sundays, so you can either memorize it or just to click the notification bell so that you get a reminder whenever we post a new video. So thank you again for watching and see you very soon. Bye!